दिस इज अ पोर्टफोलियो, पोर्टफोलियो मीन्स फंड, ओके, एंड दिस फंड इज हैविंग फोर स्टॉक्स. दीज शेयर्स आर परचेस्ड बाय एएमसी एसेट मैनेजमेंट कंपनी. These are the prices at which the stocks are purchased. And the fund is having an outstanding expenses of 2,500. Net asset, you have to calculate the net asset value. Calculate NAV if outstanding units are 2,000 units. So 2,000 units are there. You have to divide with 2,000. After calculating the net assets, this is the solution. First, take a multiplication of number of shares with trading prices. You will get the total value of stock A, total value of stock B, total value of stock C, and total value of stock D. After multiplying, you will get the result, that is total value. Total value is 22,500. This is your asset. Investment amount is your asset. Asset minus liability. This is your liability. 2,500 minus 2,500. You will get net assets after deducting this value. 22,500 minus 2,500 divided by 2,000 units. NAV is rupees 10 per unit. Mr. Kirit has invested rupees 60,000 in a long-term mutual fund with a tax benefit under Section 80C. At an NAV of 45, find the number of units acquired or purchased by Mr. Kirit if there is an entry load of 3%. So entry load is a commission you are paying at the time of purchasing the first mutual fund. Entry load you will add because this is a commission. This is your investment cost, 1.35. Number of units acquired or purchased. Total amount invested. Divided by purchase price. Your purchase price, your total investment is your purchase price. Per unit. Number of units acquired $60,000 divided by 46.35. $1,294 rounded off 1,294 units. Calculate the expected return of the security and interpret the same with the help of following information. Beta of a security is 0.5. Expected rate of return on market portfolio is 12%. Expected return on market portfolio. What is market portfolio? Market means Nifty or Sensex. Index ka portfolio hota hai. Nifty ka portfolio hai 50 stocks. NSE ka Nifty index hai. Aur uske andar 50 stocks ka index ban raha hai. Aur us 50 index ka hum log ko 12% return hai. Matlab Nifty ek saal mein 12% grow kiya hai. ठीक है? Expected rate of return on market portfolio. That means Nifty का अगर हम लोग देख रहे हैं या Sensex का देख रहे हैं तो उसके portfolio में 50 stocks का ही ग्रोथ देखा गया है, तो उन स्टॉक्स का, उन 50 स्टॉक्स का ग्रो हुआ है 12% इन 1 ईयर. रिस्क फ्री रेट ऑफ रिटर्न, दिस इज अ रिटर्न विच इज गारंटीड, विच इज अ गारंटीड रिस्क फ्री रिटर्न गिवन ऑन ट्रेजरी बिल. सो फर्स्ट, दिस इज द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन, बीटा ऑफ सिक्योरिटी दिस इज 0.5. वॉट इज बीटा ऑफ अ सिक्योरिटी? बीटा विल मेजर द सिस्टमैटिक रिस्क, मार्केट रिस्क. बीटा विल मेजर द मार्केट रिस्क. सेंसिटिविटी ऑफ माई स्टॉक, सपोज आई एम हैविंग अ स्टॉक ऑफ L&T एंड माई स्टॉक इज सेंसिटिव टू मार्केट मूवमेंट्स, दैट इज 50% सेंसिटिव टू मार्केट मूवमेंट्स. वेन द निफ्टी गोज अप बाय 10%, माई स्टॉक विल ओनली गो अप बाय 5%. ओके, that means 50% compared to market sensitive. So my stock is sensitive, beta means sensitivity to market movements. Market means nifty, market means sensex. So when sensex goes up by 10%, my stock will go up by 5%. When sensex falls by 10%, my stock will fall by 5%. So beta is the positive beta, that means it will go along with the Nifty and Sensex in the same direction. Positive beta means it is more than it is in the positive sign, 0.5. so 0.5 means it is less aggressive beta, it is not beating the market, it is going along with the market but lesser than the market. Okay, so first we have to use CAPM. Using CAPM, what is CAPM? Capital Asset Pricing Model. Formula is KE is equals to RF plus beta multiplied by return on market portfolio minus risk-free securities return minus RF. KE is equals to RF is 8 plus beta 0.5 into RM. Return on market portfolio, that is Nifty, is going up by 12% in 1 year, and the treasury bill is giving return of 8%, that is risk-free return. AE is equals to 12 minus 8, 4, 4 into 0.5, 2, 2 plus 8, 10. So first solve the bracket, multiply with the beta, and then add the risk-free rate of return. Okay, so KE is 10%, that is the expected rate of return using the CAPM model, Capital Asset Pricing Model. KE means expected return. Read the first line. Calculate the expected return of security and interpret the same with the help of following information. That means this stock, the stock of L&T which I am holding, this will give me 10% expected rate of return. If another security has an expected return of 18%, what would be its beta? Now KE is given already. KE is 18%. You will apply this formula. Now we have already KE. We have to calculate the beta. What would be the beta? Expected return is given. RF is same, 8%. RM, return on market portfolio, that is Nifty. Nifty returns are 12% and RF is treasury bill return of 8%. The beta is not given. Beta, you have to calculate it. Okay. And KE is given in the question, 18%. Expected rate of return, 18%. Is equals to 8 plus beta is not given, so write beta B into 12 minus 8 4B plus 8. Or you can do like that, 18 minus 8 is equals to 4B. So beta is 2.5 times. Beta of another security with 18% return. Beta on another security is 2.5 times. This question is expected return and beta of three stocks are given below. The returns of the stocks are 18%, 11%, 15% for LSK. Beta factor 0.7, 0.6, 1.2. If risk-free return is 9%, expected rate of return on market portfolio, that is Nifty returns, are going up by 14% in 1 year. And the treasury bill is giving return, stable return of 9%, which is risk-free. Using the CAPM method, comment on valuation of stocks and appropriate strategy. The CAPM formula is KE RF 9 plus beta 0.7 into return on market portfolio, that is Nifty returns 14. Minus 9. A is equals to 14 minus 9, 5. 5 into 0.7 and plus 9. You get 12.5. Nine plus 0.6 into Nifty returns, market portfolio returns, RM minus RF 9, 5 into 0.6, 12. Next. AE is equals to RF 9 plus beta 1.2 multiplied by 14 minus 9. AE is equals to 15. So CAPM return is 12.5 expected return is 18%. So the actual return, these are the, actually this was a mistake in the question. This is the actual return of LSK and this is the beta factor. There is a printing mistake because they are telling us to calculate the expected rate of return with CABM model. So this is the actual return of LSK. And if you can compare the actual return with the return of this, cost of equity, that is expected return of this particular L stock. Expected return is more. Actual return is more and expected return is less. So you should sell this bond. Sell this stock. Actual return is greater than the expected return. Next. The expected return is 12%, but you are getting actual return is 11%. You will buy this stock expected return is 12%, which is greater than actual return. Of 11%. Next. This is equal 15% expected return and K is also giving actual return of 15%. So this is the appropriate strategy. This is actually Jensen Alpha here. Calculated return is 12.5 and actual return is more. So positive alpha, you will sell the stock with positive Jensen Alpha. First, actual return is 11% and calculated return is 12%. So this is negative Jensen Alpha. Negative alpha means you will buy this stock. You are going to get in future more returns. If you buy this stock is undervalued. Currently, it is giving 1% less, but in future, it will give 12% return. So you will buy this stock. Next, the calculated value according to investor is 15% with CABM formula. Return actually we are getting is exactly same. So this stock we should hold it because the returns are same.